Happy about this either, dude. I know it's freaking Monday night. You really think I want to be here any more than you do, but at least it's sports, bro. Let's get down.
When my fist clenches, crack it open. Before I use it, lose my cool. When I smile, tell me some bad news before I
itself. But the game's biggest hit was delivered by punter Sam Fiasco.
For the 40, he's to the 45. Keeps his balance. Oh, and he is drilled by the punter at the 47-yard line.
In football, as in Shakespeare, the play's the thing.
To me, I always looked at football in dramaturgical terms. It was a story. It was a struggle. It was more than just the score. And I still, to this day, remember the first line of script that I wrote for Facenda, and the line of script was, it starts with a whistle and ends with a gun.
NFL films, I call them the Picasso of the sports world. They're painting a picture, and they care about literally.
You know, Harry Callis died today, and Mark Fidrich died today. Welcome to the show, John Renshaw. Great to be with you. Another late night sports buzz here in the basement. The Masters wrapped up over the weekend. We're going to talk a lot about that. A lot of high school hoops action, high school, freshman to be. That Friday night 1-2 punch or Saturday night 1-2 punch of Adidas Derby Festival into the Nike World Hoop Summit, whatever, Citibank Stadium, 5-0, Volquez, blah, blah, Grand Slam, catch it, Cubs, 5-2, Orioles win 10-9, Yankees were losing 10-0. The whole swirl of the weekend, as you know, is what we're here to cover. We do it every night, though. But the weekend, to me, is usually a blur. Because that's all I do. Unlike a lot of you, I would say most of you are more well-rounded in your lives than I am. But it's just, especially when college hoop was going on and those great times in October where you have college basketball, college football, pro football, and the playoffs. But all weekends to me are just full of, the weekends are sports. And I guess as you grow older and have kids, it's playing sports with your kids takes over instead of watching them. And that part of this I haven't gotten to yet, but I'm going to get around to it. Harry Callis and Mark Fidrich. I don't know who's listening or watching right now. I know a lot of you are. Just kidding. Yo, man, how long does this stuff last? But I feel like I'm constantly telling you how old I am. But again, I guess it's my job to talk, right? Blah, blah for now. So in 1976, Mark Fidrich was the all-star starter in 1976, and I was 8. And that's when baseball was baseball. And when trading cards were trading cards, and when Monday Night Baseball meant so much to you as a child because it was the only game on except for Saturday at noon, which was the game of the week. And there was no TBS, no ESPN, nothing, nothing. These players were still full of mystery and intrigue and rumors. And one of the men who described them is obviously Harry Callis. Harry Callis, who died today, which we'll get to in a second here, on the BJ starting five, and we'll talk about the Masters. But I remember Harry Callis from football and from inside the NFL, and we'll talk about that here in a second. Is it just me, or did you feel that CBS did a poor job in covering the Masters? That's point one on the BJ starting five tonight. Was it just my television, or were their microphones worse than my best show? Were they constantly going out? And that's not where I thought they butchered it. And I thought that worse than, you know, obviously Kenny Perry butchered himself, as did Phil and Tiger. I just thought that CBS dropped the ball in a journalistic measuring stick type of fashion. I felt that they were openly rooting for Tiger and Phil. And despite all of my other shows, I'm not that big of a moron. I understand the titanic hold, the large, gargantuan, unbelievable hold that Tiger and Phil not only have on the gooseneck of the present of the sports, but there's no doubt in my mind. And as you see the duck talk about the goose, and Kenny's daughter, the cheerleader for the Titans, and Chad Campbell, whose wife had too much makeup on but was still hot, and the allegedly gay pink cowboy. Obviously, Phil Mickelson, who's lost his boobs again. Phil's weight fluctuates more than mine, which is, I mean, I'm up and down, 25 pounds, 25 pounds, 25 pounds. I think one weekend he has boobs, the next weekend he has guns. It's absolutely amazing. I thought Jim Nantz embarrassed himself. I thought the CBS announcers embarrassed themselves by openly rooting for two competitors, by only covering two competitors when the tournament was not even being led by them. I'm talking about 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. Contributing to the letdown that was. I understand how hard it is to balance and juggle as we roll on the BJ's Hardy 5. To juggle, okay, we've got a tournament within a tournament. And I thought a tournament within the tournament was cool. Don't get me wrong. You can hit that like a champ. Don't get me wrong. I love the tournament within the tournament. But CBS messed up in the way they covered it, rooting for Phil and Tiger and almost lying to the public. They didn't lie. John Hood, has he lied to the public? He didn't lie to the public about his commitment to Kentucky. Did Mike Mara, did he get lied to about from Pitino, the best shooter he ever saw? Why would Rick Pitino even say that? I like Mara. Bledsoe, he ain't going to Kentucky. He said, I ain't nobody's number two. I'll go up to Cincinnati just to stick it to you. He said, don't come calling me. Daniel Orton's a rebounding machine. So light skin and clean. Like Lonnie Baxter, but lean. I love, he pulls down his outlet pass. I mean, he was unselt-like in his outlets. It just seemed like rebound, baseball pass, rebound, two-hand outlets, rebound, outlet, rebound, outlet. It was beautiful. Siva is the best Louisville player, obviously, in my opinion, so far. Things can change. I mean, Buckles had a good game. Yeah, I went to the skills challenge Friday night, and then, of course, I stayed home Saturday. I think Rob and I wouldn't have stayed home if it wasn't on TV. Siva's unreal. I'm not here to deny that. And Van Treese played a lot better in the game than he looked to me on Friday night. I can't assume that you heard everything I said Friday because I broke down every single player that played. I was a big Maurice Creek fan on Friday and remain a big fan of his as well. We'll talk about all the Indiana players and then what happened after that game. John Wall, I can't remember seeing anything like that. But let's roll on to point three. Are those guys on a little extra caffeine right there? Harry Callis died in the booth, which I'm imagining that he probably would have wanted to. You know, you hear that a lot. Hey, Jack Nicklaus, where would you die? I guess on the 18th. You know, what's interesting, and obviously you can look at some of the nuggets there on Harry's career, Mr. Callis' career, Harry Callis' career. We used to have a radio station upstairs, I guess, that Rob and Brian and I worked at. And let's see, the Phillies won the World Series in November, and you know, we weren't name-dropping or asset-dropping or anything, but we did have Harry Callis on like maybe 2 weeks after the Phillies won the World Station, and then Cumulus Media like went bankrupt and fired 19 radio stations in one day, allegedly. So we must have talked to him in early November, which is kind of weird, but for anyone that was raised on the HBO decade, and I'm talking pre-MTV, but you remember when MTV came to town. MTV was a rumor, and it kept coming, and so was cable. That's what she said, and they kept coming down from one block to the next block. You didn't know. And you got HBO and Nick Bonacani, and you got the quarterback, oh boy, from the Chiefs, Lan Dawson, Purdue. And Harry Callis was the voice of those two of the highlights of every game. John Facenda, obviously, the original NFL guy. And Mark Fittrich was just the first freak ever, man. He was the first and greatest, coolest freak that I ever remember as a child. I was, again, if he's an All-Star in 76, and I was 10 in 78, so I was 8 years old. So I had never seen someone cross any kind of lines of what is quote-unquote normal social behavior. Not an athlete, at least. I'd seen weird uncles at parties, and my parents told me, stay away from that man. Of course, I didn't find out why until later that he had dead bodies and these other people. But Mark Fittrich was the very first guy on television. His hair was so electric. They called him the Big Bird, and Bird because he looked like he was off of Sesame Street. He talked to the ball. He rubbed the dirt and talked to the dirt. He was like Al Hrabowski, but friendly. Do you remember? So, your thoughts on the Masters? Was it just me? Or did you think that they were rooting a little bit too much for Phil and Tiger, and how bad do you feel for Kenny or not? Any thoughts on the broadcasters as well? So just stick it right here on the CW. We got you covered.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, Two Men Steal a Fortune as leading ladies.
Are you ready?
Tuesday night at 8 on the CW Louisville.
Don't you want to do something different? Maybe learn something about yourself.
So nice having you here.
Maybe Ellie's ready for me now.
My birth mother? I just want to see her.
Donna, what's going on?
It's her.
Go.
90210. Tuesday night at 9 on the CW Louisville.
Ernesto's is not your typical Mexican restaurant. Ernesto's is more like a Mexican sports bar with a life-size projector screen and high-def TVs. Ernesto's, your home for Mexican food and all of the games. During the games, enjoy half-price appetizers, tons of drink specials on domestics, imports, and drafts, wells, margaritas, of course. Next time you're looking for a place to watch the games or a fiesta, remember, there are 4 Ernesto's conveniently located near you.
The new season of Secrets of Louisville Chefs is at a new time, 5:30 p.m. on the CW Louisville, starting February. Kevin Harnett and Kelly Kay take you behind the scenes at Louisville's most popular restaurants and reveal the chef's secrets so you can make the food you love to eat out at home. Join Dean Corbett with Tim Laird in the Kitchen Theater, where Louisville's top chefs reveal their secrets before a live studio audience. New local TV at 5:30, Secrets of Louisville Chefs on the CW Louisville.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, Two Men Steal a Fortune as leading ladies.
Talk about 1976. I remember jumping up and down in my bed with a tennis racket, and this Chinese guy that lived next door to me named up the hill, Ronnie D. We used to make out, not me and the Chinese boy, but me and the neighborhood girls between his yard and my yard, because there was this big garden. But we were jumping up and down on the bed with tennis rackets, and that's not even a pseudonym, which is the wrong word. Real tennis rackets, playing that AC/DC as loud as possible, Back in Black. I don't see how you could ever be in a bad mood when you either hear that or if you hear it loud, like Smart Choppers plays it. Smart Choppers has the absolute best stereo needs for your car, your boat, your Winnebago, whatever you need. Go visit Smart Choppers. They've got you covered, whether it's methane, which I'm pretty much obviously into, and music. Methane and music, hand in hand, day man, night man, troll, pay the toll. 4200 Produce Road, a big Steeler fan. Other than that, he's a pretty good guy. Jayhawk Can is happy, I would imagine, because not only did he see Elijah Johnson play this weekend, he saw the other big kid play in the Nike Hoop Summit, and Kansas is going to be insane next year. Go Hawk. Go ahead, Jayhawk.
Hey, freaking show. I see you.
How do you stay up on a Monday? I thought you couldn't stay up at all, let alone a Monday. It must be a weird, weird time in your life.
Well, hey, I got breaking news for you.
Okay. Xavier Henry.
Jerron Collins and Cole Aldridge both announced they're coming back next year.
Well, I knew you wouldn't call and say that. I knew the punchline before you even finished, you old dirty. So you got to be pretty jacked about next year. And look how close you came this year. Your coach won Coach of the Year. You didn't just, as a Kansas fan, you're on a good run right now.
Oh, dude. Hey, you remember? I don't know if you remember this or not, but after we won it in 2008.
You told me you were more athletically talented than, and I laughed at you, even after losing 7 starters.
Yes, yes. And it's starting to, my plan is starting to come together. The mad scientist is putting it together, and I'm looking forward to
next year.
But you know what?
What?
I really don't think that I just got this feeling in my gut that Orton really wants to come to play for Bill Self.
Well, Orton and Henry hate each other, I think. And Jayhawk Kent, I got to go. I appreciate you staying up. I don't think Henry and Orton are going to play together. I could be wrong. Sean, you've got Henry. Leave Orton alone. Leave us to us Cat fans. Sean, you're on the air. Go ahead, buddy.
What's up, part-time?
What's up, part-time? What's up, Geyser? What's up, Pink Jeep in 86?
Hey, you lay off Phil Mickelson's man boobs.
Hey, I've got enough to cover the whole world on just one side, right there. Right there, just, it's, but you know what? If I flex, stone. What do you got for me?
Hey, does Mike Mara not look like Diebendorf?
Diebendorf on what? Extra, right? No, no, Diebendorf, Pope of Greenwich Village, any, and I'm Italian, but any kind of stereotype you can come up with, you add 10 to it and you get Mike Mara. When you throw in the size of the nose, the amount of the tattoos, the amount of the gel, and thank you for the phone call, Sean. If you talk the nature of the tattoo, a clown in a straitjacket, but you know what? I think he held everything. To be honest, I've become a Mike Mara fan because Patino threw him under the bus. What is that man thinking, putting that kind of pressure on a kid, saying he's the... Patino speaks in tongues anyway, juggles snakes. You know, that's the only thing I can ever find that's a fault in him, other than late game adjustments, maybe not being prepared. Yeah, Amanda. Michigan State's man-to-man defense kind of caught us off guard. That was Earl, you know, probably saying it differently than he wanted to say. But you knew they were going to play man-to-man, right, Earl? But why would you call Mike Mara the best shooter you ever saw, even if it was true? And it's not, obviously it's not true. But I am a big fan of Mara. I don't know if I'll be here to see the season start, but I'll be here to root for him. I liked what Amber said. She showed a video once, and congratulate Sosa. Sosa was there Friday night, and he was cheering really hard for Siva. And Sosa is going to lose playing time to Siva, but they'll need each other. Obviously, Siva is a natural freak. He's going to become a cult hero here at Louisville, as is Mara and Vantrese, I think, for all their different roles. Buckles, I want to know if he's going to be any more than a follow dunker if he doesn't put 30 pounds on. But I remember they asked Earl what he thought of Arizona, and he said, I don't know, man, I've never been out there, allegedly. And then he goes, we played in the tournament there earlier this year. He goes, we did, man? All right. Catch all games at BJ Sports Pub. 70-17 Global Drive on the Green Belt. BJ, something going on every night. Thursday, pool tournament. Thursday and Friday, Cindy's karaoke. Saturday, DJ Rip. Monday, Nationwide Tips. Tuesday, Dollar Cans of Beer. Wednesday's One Man Band. Roger Esser's BJ Sports Pub on the Green Belt.
Now I was getting ready to make a left turn, stopped, and I looked in my rearview mirror, and all I seen was a truck coming full speed. It was just a slam bang. My car spinned around, my kids were screaming, and I jumped out and grabbed them out of the car because I thought the car was going to blow. The insurance companies gave me the whole runaround. I was so confused, and I didn't know what to do, so I called 1-800-ASK-GARY, and I'm glad I did.
Hey, you've got to check out Shack in the Back. It is real open pit barbecue. Proudly smoked to perfection. Slow cooked with extra care on 406 Mount Holly Road in Fairdale, Kentucky. They've got you covered. Dine in, carry out, drive through, desserts, catering, hickory grilled ribs on Friday and Saturday nights, live country and bluegrass music. It's in Fairdale. No event too large or too small to be catered. We cater to them all. All of our barbecue at the Shack in the Back.
One source for all things multimedia. Interactive Media Lab. One source for all your web development and hosting needs. CD and DVD production. Corporate event planning and production. Video production and animation. Online media streaming. Audio production and sound design. InteractiveMediaLab.com.
Catch all games at BJ Sports Pub. 70-17 Global Drive on the Green Belt. BJ, something going on every night. Thursday, pool tournament. Thursday and Friday, Cindy's karaoke. Saturday, DJ Rip. Monday, Nationwide Tips. Tuesday, Dollar Cans of Beer. Wednesday's One Man Band. Roger Esser's BJ Sports Pub on the Green Belt.
I see your dirty face. Thank you.
always sad, sad, sad when college basketball is over, whether it's a highlight package or whether it's the season. To be very honest, I think I said something to Rob today in the parking lot. I'm like, it's over, isn't it? When we pulled in, because the Masters is your last little tease, and then I guess your Derby and your playoffs help some of you out, but it's over for me. But at least we start off our new reason to go out and eat. Look at the offerings and the deals we have at LouisvilleSportsBuzz.com. I don't know how they pull it off, but check it out. Seriously, I'm not even lying. It's not even a fake. If you go to the website, you will get a gift card that says $100 worth of food from Roosters or $50 worth of food from Penn Station, but you're only paying half price for it. So it's all done legally. However you people with credit cards do things, I don't know. I assume some of you know how to do those things. I would have to have things like slipped in my pocket or in my drink. But Furlongs and Roosters and Penn Stations and the Derby Dinner Classics, all half price deals. They're not marked up and then cut down half price at all. It's just an amazing deal. So you'll get $100 or $50 worth of food on your card and beverages, some apply, for paying half of that money while supply lasts. No money. Bickle on the phone doesn't fast, but he needs to because he's got a big round belly. Hello, Mr. You called me, was it Friday night or Thursday night? You might have been a little bit of buzz and said, when are you going to get over here with that marriage counseling?
Well, yeah, my wife has been wanting you to come over, dude. We have dinner or whatever.
Yeah, I was there.
You're more welcome. You know what, John? You just don't call me back.
No, sir.
I got two questions.
I was there for lunch today.
Listen, it's real good.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
The Masters.
Yes, sir.
Why do you want to watch somebody playing for power when you got guys going out and hitting it and doing it all and trying to score?
Okay.
That's the reason why they put
why they put
Tin Cup on ESPN.
No, they put Tin Cup on for you.
And that
says it all. They put on Apocalypse Now for me. Number two?
But my other thing is, I watched some of the Derby Classic, and, I mean, 295 points in 48 minutes. I mean, I don't care where these kids are going to school at, man. These guys have talent.
Oh, well, see, I'm on the other side of that. It was the most, thank you for the phone call. It was the most boring 150-point game I've ever seen in my life. There was no, and it was, I watched it on TV. It just didn't seem to be a star-laden game, and as soon as you turned on Fox Sports 2 minutes later after the Adidas Classic, you saw where all the stars were in Portland. And that's bullcrap for CBS only to cover Tiger and Phil and ignore Angel Cabrera after doing an hour-long special on Seve Ballesteros, one of my mom's heroes. You do an hour-long special on Seve, and then you don't even mention Cabrera's name until basically Jim Nance is able to recover himself from his bunker of insanity once his heroes. He openly makes love to Phil Mickelson and Tiger Woods' golf game on the air. He openly makes love to the game of golf on the air. He's one of the best announcers of our generation, Jim Nance. He has always crossed the line when it comes to golf in loving it too much on the air. He's not a talk show host allowed to do that. He's there to cover it. And his love drips and oozes through your TV set in a very uncomfortable fashion. But he was like, I remember the day after Bush got, how you doing up there? Bush got reelected the first time, which was a horrible day for all of us, obviously. Katie Couric wore black on the Today Show that morning. So this would be what? If Obama just got elected in 2008, so 4 years, 2004. And when Kerry, who, great candidate, that's all we can come up with, Kerry, and his wife, the vampire mustard ketchup heir, she wore black on the Today Show, and I thought she crossed the line that day, and she was almost in tears the whole day. And I think Jim Nance crosses the line, not only, but mostly CBS crosses the line for their coverage of just Phil and Tiger. Now, I'll probably come out here and be saying, why no more Phil and Tiger? But I'm just a whiny biatch.
This is Oni Zim from Louisiana. My grandson, Charlie, learned the culture from me and now is taking his passion for good food and good times to Furlongs in Louisville. Come try delicious seafood, steaks, salads, and pasta served with a taste of Louisiana. Not too spicy, not too pricey. You'll love the relaxing setting, a favorite for Kentucky horse racing fans. Plan now to meet your friends at Furlongs. Tell them Oni Zim sent you. Furlongs, now open for lunch and dinner at the corner of Shelbyville Road at Hurstbourne Lane.
Watson's turns up the fun meter this summer.
Offering luxurious six-person spas with 45 jets, LED lights, CD stereo system, and a relaxing waterfall.
Originally $74.99, now just $49.99.
A four-person spa is just $18.88.
Save 40 to 60% off on top-brand outdoor casual furniture.
Including over 100 wicker, cast aluminum, and wrought iron groups.
During the Spring Fever Sale, only at Watson's.
We have all the fun.
One source for all things multimedia. Interactive Media Lab. One source for all your web development and hosting needs. CD and DVD production. Corporate event planning and production. Video production and animation. Online media streaming. Audio production and sound design. InteractiveMediaLab.com.
To make a Penn Station East Coast sub, you need the freshest ingredients. A Penn Station Grill Master and one of those official spatula thingies. Serve on our hearth-baked bread. Add fresh-cut fries and hand-squeezed lemonade, and suddenly, you don't care what they call that grill-em-a-bob. You're just glad Penn Station uses it so well.
For great taste and value, nobody does it better than Penn Station. Enjoy any great-tasting Penn Station sub, fresh-cut fries, and 22-ounce drink, all for a monthly special price. See you grill soon.
Spirits are using me, larger voices come calling. What heaven brought you and me cannot be forgotten.
Love a little, that's not even Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. I think that's just Stills. I might be wrong. Yellow Cab, never leave you standing still like a fool in the rain. Never, ever, ever, ever. They will take you where you need to go, like Robert De Niro in Taxi Driver. Just kidding, what a freaky movie. Harvey Keitel, the pimp in that movie to me, along with Jodie Foster. You know, she's a little young to talk about on the air, but she does play a hooker in a movie, and a hooker. You can do a lot worse than that. Get in the cab, man. It's that easy. 636-5511, Cardinal, Checker, Louisville, Yellow Cardinal Checker. 636-5511. 636-5511. PRP Mike knows if he needs a cab to call 636-5511. What's going on? I think Stephen Stills wants to talk. What's up, PRP Mike?
Hey, what's going on, man? I used one of them yellow checkers just the other day. I just wanted to share three thoughts of mine if I could do.
Yes, sir.
All right, one thing. Man boobs, there's nothing wrong with them. That just means that you do not take steroids.
And you're getting old, but I've had them since I was 11. Go ahead.
All right, my second thing about the Masters this Sunday.
Yeah.
You don't mention Tiger Woods or Phil Mickelson. People are not going to watch. That's just
I understand. You're right, but it still doesn't make it right. But you are, reality is on your side. You're 100% right. But that doesn't make it right. That just makes it street right. It doesn't make it right, but nothing's right anymore in sports. Next.
And third, last thing, and this is a little off subject, but it is about sports.
Who cares?
Now, what do you think about the whole Michael Vick thing? And do you really think that he should have spent 2 years in for killing dogs?
Hey, thank you very much for that. And I'm definitely not going to fall into that Vick trap. Have a good night. I think, like everybody else's offenses, that through time they will look a lot less worse than they did when they happened. However, Vic's dead. Not because just women love pets. You know the way that I feel about the dog, Spencer, that died in my arms in Kansas City, Missouri one morning when I woke up. 14 years I had that dog. My cat now, Nova, is really the only reason I live. He will never, so there's not, people equate sometimes pets and women, which is true, but there's almost as much men that love their pets. And he will never, the relationship between pets and humans will never stop. He'll never escape his thing. Thoughts on marijuana and what he did, or it, let's just say if it was something different, or he was a young kid, it's gonna be hard to escape that pet deal. But you know what? There was a point in time where Elton John and Paul McCartney and Keith Richards were running around with pounds of heroin and cocaine in their luggage, and they were arrested for it. And they were put on TV and put in jail. And then the Queen, fast forward 25 years later, is knighting them in her castle, Buckingham Palace. So Ask Pee Wee Herman. It's really never dead till it's dead. Hey, James, how are you, buddy? Thanks for staying on hold. What's on your mind?
Well, I watched that game Saturday, parts of it, and I'm a huge UK fan, but to me, even though there's no defense played, I think Indiana has the best class coming in.
They do. Well,
that Hall kid's crazy. I think he's going to be something good. And if Crean keeps doing this, they're going to compete nationally quicker than Kentucky and Louisville both.
See, I want to give you a chance, and I want to agree. I just think you're coming with a kind of an angle that you're trying to shove it down Kentucky's fans a little, their throats a little fast there. But I agree with you that their class is very awesome. Christian Watford, the first night, really impressed me when I saw the skills competition. And the guy that I liked, other than Elijah Johnson, I think that's his name, going to Kansas, as my most consistent player, and Snare, who's going to Florida State, is Maurice Creek, who's going to Indiana. Now, Holes is going to be fun to either love on or hate on, just like Shane. And now Shane is a Kentucky fan, so there's nothing wrong with him saying, you know, Mike Mara kind of makes it even easier for me to hate him or root against him, because you're supposed to root against blue and red and red and blue. And, of course, we're trying to bring that crimson back in this triangle so it gets more interesting, you know what I'm saying? But Holes is so little. Is he a little white boy, or does he have game? It's going to be fun. We'll be right back.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, Two Men Steal a Fortune as leading ladies.
Something this hot, you need to know. So I'm going to put you on Peep Game. It's Quest. This thing is so crazy around the whole board. I mean, you can meet a whole load of official local singles, keeping it real all day. I always have a hot time, and all my girls are doing it too. It's free to try, so pick up your phone and call now.
Try it free. Call 502-814-8888 now. Enjoy one of life's little pleasures. Yoplait has a sweetly satisfying taste and creamy texture that you can't resist. Yoplait in 25 delicious flavors. It is so good.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, Two Men Steal a Fortune as leading ladies.
On the next People's Court.
She screams, hangs up their phone, and calls again.
Cursed out by a cranky customer.
I was scared.
He's lying out of his teeth. Listen, miss.
Don't call me miss again. Your Honor, I'd also accept your highness. If I was a man, you wouldn't say, listen, mister.
Next People's Court.
Tomorrow at 6 on the CW Louisville.
Bruce Springsteen's alleged affair and the country's first transgender mayor, how he went from this to this. Next Insider.
Tomorrow at 7 on the CW Louisville.
The fans loved him. They called him Bird after Sesame Street's Big Bird. They loved his style, the way he'd talk to the baseball or fill up the hole on the pitcher's mound.
People thought I was strange. I didn't think anything of it until people started saying, hey, you know what you're doing out there? Yeah, pitching. Oh, before you pitch. I mean, yeah, filling up the hole. I don't like it. You want me to get the crowd crew out here every time? I mean, you know, stop the game, crowd crew, you know, fix the mound, you know? I mean, because eventually then I wear into my own hole. You know what I'm saying? And it was a thing of, why go into someone else's hole? That's the way he pitches. Pitch the way you pitch, and if he wants to go in your hole, let him, you know? So yeah, I just always filled it up. I mean, that's... It was weird. People thought, you know, and I was not conscious of it. You know, I just did it naturally, and people thought it was weird. I mean, writers, that's what made writers start going, you know, oh, we got someone different here. They said I was talking the ball. Here I am, I'm on the mound going, okay, I got a guy on first base now. I got this guy coming up. I'm talking to myself. It was like getting some nerves off you going, God, I'm in trouble again. How am I going to get out of this? Okay, calm down, relax, and that's just what I do.
My boy, he'd go to the buzz store. You think he was buzzed up a little bit? He'd get $100 off of Rooster's Chicken Wings for $50. He'd take his girl out. He had all kinds of girls in 76. He didn't even need to break Furlongs. Go over and see my boy Furlongs. Woody runs that place. He is so cool. Go say hi to Woody. Break out a card from LouisvilleSportsBuzz.com and you will be set. And I told some of you earlier in the show about Mark the Bird Fidrich. Could I have explained him any better? I didn't even get a chance to hear what he was going to say in that video. But I love that guy, man. I love 1976. Isn't Dazed and Confused made in the summer of 1976? Everything was the summer of 1976 for me. All right. Travis, thank you for holding, brother. Are you there?
Yes, I am.
Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry I got a little croaked up, but if you miss talk, I'd like to speak to people on a few subjects.
Yes, sir.
I went to the Derby Classic the other night. There was no defense, of course. You know, it was dunked upon. But the Orton boy looked good, and I can't think of the other Kentucky commitment. But
John Hood, he went five.
Yeah, Hood.
Yeah, that's about it for Kentucky, I believe. And, of course, Bledsoe, you might have had a chance at. What else you got for me, buddy?
Well, Kenny Perry.
Oh.
That's what I say. Oh, it hurt me.
He killed himself. That's what's so sad about it, right?
Yes, yes, there is. You know, I mean, he made a good shot out of that bunker, but couldn't make the knife and butter come within an inch, you know.
It was amazing how it all got laid out there for him, and that's why I think golf, thank you for the phone call, sir. That's why I've always thought that golf on Sundays, and I've like convinced more of my friends on this subject, these are friends that weren't into sports, and they definitely were never going to watch golf if they weren't going to watch football, right? If I couldn't get them on college football, how the hell am I going to get them on Sunday golf? And I still have friends that won't watch golf. If you just learn, i.e., the rivalries in the histories of a Tennessee and Alabama. And if you're into drama, the unscripted variety. And if you're into meltdowns, coming to Jesus meetings, finding yourself at Sunday on golf with TV on certain Sundays. Not every Sunday. Maybe not the Houston Open with VJ's running away. Okay? But you'll never, other than tennis, there is no other one man sport, I guess, that comes to mind. And that's why they call golf the most difficult sport in the world. There's only one other one that comes in that argument, and that's hitting a Major League Baseball. But if you're into watching the most unbelievable highs and lows and mental battles, if you just, I don't have to preach to you because you're a sports fan. You're up this late. You know what the hell is going on. Like my girl, Amy. Amy, how are you? What's going on?
Hey, I just want to talk about the guy that called a few minutes ago. He was hyping up the Indiana players.
See, I knew it.
He's
yeah.
just a loser Kentucky fan because all the Kentucky recruits suck. No matter if Calipari's there or not, they all.
Probably want to get that for her, Brian. Not let her do it on her own, even though she's capable of it. Thank you, Amy, for your colorful thoughts on the new rivalry between Kentucky and Indiana. Jones, we appreciate your in-depth analysis of both recruiting classes. We really like your precise breakdowns of each kid's handle, and I really, really didn't know what you could use a screen that way. I knew about the hedge and the slip screen from Billis, but you taught me new ways to pick and roll, which I really appreciate it. Hey, let's bust on out of here, but we can give Chris a hot 30. What's up, Chris? Are you there, brother? I lost Chris. I'll come back and get him at 267-2422, 267-2422. Got some more good Jocks Magic box cuts to hit. Got that After Midnight Jam. We're talking about the Masters, Harry Callis, and Rapid Fire. It's all good.
Catch all games at BJ Sports Pub. 70-70 Global Drive on the Green Belt. BJ, something going on every night.
Thursday, pool tournament.
Thursday and Friday,
Cindy's karaoke.
Saturday,
DJ Rip.
Monday,
Nationwide
Hold. Tuesday,
Dollar Cans of Beer.
Wednesdays, One Man Band.
Rochester's
BJ Sports Pub on the Green Belt.
Hi, I'm Chevy Ray Perkins.
and welcome to Chubby Ray's Original Louisville Pizza Company in Jaytown. For the last 17 years, we've been serving great food and entertainment. We've got all your comfort food favorites, from our famous 5-pound fat teddy burger to wings, subs, and of course our signature pizza. Everyone's welcome. Bring your family or bring your buddies. We're all about making your dining experience fun. So the next time you're hungry, remember Chubby Ray's in J-Town.
I'm traveling southbound. A car's coming eastbound. Trying to get between two cars. Instead of inching out where I may have seen the nose of the car, she bolted out and hit the front end of my car. It felt like a jolt in my neck, and I felt it down in the middle of my back. After leaving the emergency room, I went home, saw the commercial, and I called 1-800-AS-GARY, and Gary and his staff gave me a lot of relief and made me feel a lot better.
Hey, you've got to check out Shack in the Back. It is real open pit barbecue, proudly smoked to perfection, slow cooked with extra care on 406 Mount Holly Road in Fairdale, Kentucky. They've got you covered, dine in, carry out, drive through, desserts, catering, hickory grilled ribs on Friday and Saturday nights, live country and bluegrass music. It's in Fairdale. No event too large or too small to be catered. We cater to them all. All of our barbecue at the Shack in the Back. Catch all games at BJ Sports Pub. 70-17 Global Drive on the Green Belt. BJ, something going on every night. Thursday, pool tournament. Thursday and Friday, Cindy's karaoke. Saturday, DJ Rip. Monday, Nationwide Total. Tuesday, Dollar Cans of Beer. Wednesday's One Man Band. Rochester's BJ Sports Pub on the Green Belt.
We will give you a chance for sure to see if you know how to knock out Rapid Fire. Right there is Rapid Fire 101. You call up and you say one sentence about anyone or anything. All I gotta do is dial the number and get out of my ear. 267-2422, just dial it. Give me a movie quote, give me some play-by-play. Give me a music lyric, give me trivia. Say something funny, mean, weird, or creative. It's asking a lot at 12:14 on any night, let alone a Monday. But hey, it's Tuesday morning and today the sun rises. Oh my gosh, everything is possible. Bull crap. Hey, Rapid Fire, you're first up, go.
What's up, Johnny? My favorite Seinfeld is the dinner party, the Gore-Tex chocolate vodka, black and white cookie. Cogar 19 loves you, Pete.
Thank you. I like it when that little weasel busts George for double dipping. I think that guy's a weasel, but I never thought about the double dipping until that episode. It taught me something. How come? Never mind. Rapid Fire, you're live. Go.
Johnny was a good friend. Yeah, he was a brother of mine. We were imaginary comic book superheroes. Kids doing fine. Kentucky sucks.
I just like the imaginary comic book superheroes. That's all I agree with. Rapid Fire, I think that lady might agree with you, Amy, though, about the last part. Rapid Fire, you're live on the air. Go ahead, bro. Psych, just when I thought you were there. You left me standing. Maybe it's a man's ear, you're right. Hey, you're on Rapid Fire. Go ahead, lady. All right, no, lady. Rapid
Hello?
Yeah, talk right now.
Hey.
Hi.
2, 3, 4. Kentucky loses.
2, 3, 4. Can G.J. Villarino hit the back door? Rapid Fire, you are live on the air. Go ahead. I get to hear him twice. Because you're TV. How you doing, buddy?
Good.
What are you wearing?
What?
What are you wearing? Come on.
That's a little weird.
I know. I'm buddy. He said little. Seriously, what do you have on?
Maryland Duck.
Who?
Maryland.
Maryland does suck, but what are you wearing, kid? Give me something to work with, man. That's all you can do is hang up. Hey, Rapid Fire, you're live. Maryland sucks. Rapid Fire, you're live on the air. Go.
Going back to the Final Four at Cali. Cali.
Yeah, Shepard, Padgett, and McGlure.
I love it.
Yeah, Tubby, Shepard, Padgett, and McGlure. Rock on, Kentucky. 3 straight Final Fours. Rapid Fire, you're on the air. Go. Rapid Fire, you're on the air. Hi.
Hey, this is Glenn.
Hi, Glenn. You're that close.
And down the stretch they go. And here comes JoJo. Here comes JoJo. Here comes JoJo.
Okay, what's JoJo gonna do?
Tell me what you're going to say on the air.
JoJo wins.
He does?
He wins.
All right, stay right there. Okay, we're going to put you on, okay? Good boy. Hey, rapid fire, you're almost last. Go ahead. Here comes JoJo. Here comes JoJo. Wait a minute. Go ahead, little one. Talk right now, little person. Why are you up this late? I hear you in the background. If you're a midget, I'm sorry. You were a little kid. Just hang up on them. They got really nervous and scared, and I'm pretty sure the mushroom-laced horse race probably tripped them out. They're still on.
Hey.
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
What's up?
I don't know, man. What's up with you?
Not much. What's going on, brother?
Ow. I guess we have... Dump that. Yeah, what'd he say? Quick one there. We put to bed another chapter of Rapid Fire, thanks to our good buddies at Smart Choppers and SmartChoppersInc.com. You can visit them at 4200 Produce Road. I have a feeling JoJo, this is your life, JoJo Dancer. You can answer who that movie is about. That trivia question in the next 5 seconds. I will give you this television station. You can have it. I love it. It's Richard Pryor, I think. This is your life, JoJo Dancer. It's a pretty sick movie. Hey, stick with us right here on WBKI. Ernesto's is not your typical Mexican restaurant. Ernesto's is more like a Mexican sports bar with a life-size projector screen and high-def TVs. Ernesto's, your home for Mexican food and all of the games. During the games, enjoy half-price appetizers, tons of drink specials on domestics, imports, and drafts, wells, margaritas, of course. Next time you're looking for a place to watch the games or a fiesta, remember, there are 4 Ernesto's conveniently located near you.
Some people might think that all banks are interested in is counting money. And while we put our number crunchers up against the best of them, there's one thing we know for sure. There's more to life. Like the hometown relationships you've created with us. At River City Bank, they are the reason we thrive. Locally owned and built on strong community values, we actively find ways to preserve our roots. After all, we work here, live here, and invest here too. Which makes us less of a bank that counts your money and more of a bank that you can count on. River City Bank, FDIC.
Hey, hi. Hi. Could you take all of these in for me, please?
All of them?
Well, it's the Boston cream pie and the apple turnovers and the white chocolate strawberries and the key lime pie.
So you need them let out?
No, in.
Out.
In.
Out.
No, in.
Yoplait Light, with 14 delicious flavors at 100 calories, it only tastes fattening.
Out?
Okay, I was just outside and then I came in, so if you could...
On a Tuesday edition of the Dave and Scott Show in the Morning, Mike Florio from ProFootballTalk.com. A little draft talk for you.
And we'll also have a little NBA playoff talk all tomorrow. Dave and Scott Show.
Next TMZ, lingerie models just fall into our lap.
It's every guy's last chance of a hookup at a bar fantasy. Everybody's crowding around, and who comes out of the bar? 2 smoking hot Victoria's Secret models.
What do we have to drink today, ladies?
Next TMZ.
Tomorrow at 7:30 on the CW Louisville.
In our ringside, on top of the world. Oh, yeah.
We're gonna die one night. Died in his bed. A bottle of whiskey, sleeping tablets by his head. Jonah's life passed him by like a warm sun.
Yeah, not really about me dying, about Mark Fidrich and Harry Callis. Gosh, you look at the young Angels pitcher who was a can't-miss number one prospect and the announcer for the Tigers as well, George Kell. It's been a real sad April for those true diehard baseball fans that are out there. I would lie to you if I would tell you that I was still a diehard baseball fan, but was I a diehard Mark the Bird Fidrich and Harry Callis fan? Without a doubt. And without a doubt, you can remove all doubts. If you ever need a cab, just give them a call. Yellow checker cardinal. They're almost as infamous as me. 636-5511. I think they're seen more visibly around town. I think people know them. They have leather-bound books. I don't. It's fake leather. 636-5511, P.L. and Stinnett. 636-5511, Albert King, Damon Heward. 636-5511, yellow, checker, Louisville, Cardinal, Cabs. They will take you wherever you need to go. Jump in. Tell them that I sent you. Tell them to turn on the radio and look for my show. And then say, no, not that station. Say, JoJo, here comes JoJo, who we got to bet all our money on this year, obviously, even though we're supposed to go with the 73-year-old owner because the media tells us it's a great story, which it is. There's no doubt about that. 267-2422, Shane, Rob, upstairs. If you guys want to hook me up at 267-2422. And, yeah, go ahead and just put old boy on the air. Hey, Rick, how you doing, brother, man? I just didn't want to leave you on hold. How are you, Rick?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
I can't complain, sir. What's on your mind?
The way you get your friends to watch golf on Sundays,
yeah,
is to take them out and let them try to play it once.
Yeah, you mean as far as proving it, how hard it is? I would have to agree with you 100%. I don't know if that's going to make them watch it. Do you think it would?
Oh, yeah. That's where I got started. I wouldn't watch it before, but now I do all the time.
Do you think it's the hardest sport in the world, or you think hitting a Major League Baseball is harder?
Well, I've never tried to hit a Major League Baseball before, so I can't really comment on that, but I play a lot of golf.
Yes, sir.
I know how that is.
My buddy Rob played over the weekend. He had 7 pars. I don't think I have ever had 7 pars in my life. And thank you for your phone call. And look at me preaching the golf gospel. And I've never even broken 100. I love it. I love playing it. I never get a chance to play it anymore because I've kind of been in a 10-year rut. But gosh, I've never missed a Sunday's Masters in my life, ever. I remember Seve Ballesteros. I mean, my mom loved him so much. That's why I just don't understand why they would spend an hour on him and God bless him with his brain tumor, and then they wouldn't mention Cabrera's name like it was cancer or something. The reverse cancer. It's horrible. Why would they not mention Cabrera's name, let alone Chad Campbell? I understand that Phil and Tiger are right there, and it's an insane tournament within a tournament. But they kind of just pee-peed on Chad Campbell and Cabrera and barely touched on Kenny Perry. I'm not even a Kentucky guy or a Western Kentucky guy. This has been the oldest person to ever win. But they want to talk. Ian Baker Fitch want to tell me how much he was tingling at 12 when there was a whole other tournament going on, and you barely catch one of the guys, I think at 12, Kenny Perry making a birdie. I think it's just, I thought it was bad coverage. They can't ruin my day. It's really about the only thing I remain passionate about anymore. College basketball and announcers. You say Jeff is up next on our last 45 seconds. Jeff from Jeff. What's going on, Jeff?
What do you think the chances are that Kentucky gets John Wall and Xavier Henry?
Thank you for your phone call. 1 out of 2 is all you're allowed to ask for if you were ever to be given that unbelievable blessing. So what are the chances? Henry, no. John Wall, 40%? 40% chance of John Wall.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, 2 men steal a fortune as leading ladies.
People are getting respect online by turning to Cricket Broadband, and they're getting it for just $40 a month. Call 1-800-884-6288. From your desktop to your laptop, get fast, unlimited internet access all over town. Surf the web, download music, even become an internet singing sensation.
Give it to me when you get home.
On America's most affordable 3G network. Unlimited mobile broadband, just $40 a month. Isn't it time your wireless company gave you and your wallet some
RESPCG?
Right now, get a USB modem for just $59. Call 1-800-884-6288. Click mycricket.com/broadband or come into a Cricket store today. That's respect for your wallet. Respect for you. Cricket.
Wake up, Louisville, Roosters on Preston has the whole family taken care of. Bring the folks to Roosters for their complete dinner menu. Roosters still specializes in wings, and Mondays from 5 to 10, they're just 39 cents. Roosters is open at 11 a.m. every day for lunch. Pizzas, subs, and salads. Great food, happy hour specials, $10 domestic buckets all day and night, 40 plasma TVs, and a full family menu. Roosters has a lot to crow about. Roosters on Preston Highway between Fern Valley and the Outer Loop.
Cocktails, home cooking, and theater in the round. Experience the Derby Dinner Playhouse, just 3 minutes from downtown. Now showing the musical made for Elvis fans, All Shook Up. And coming soon, Two Men Steal a Fortune as leading ladies.
Hey, not only a great job done by Miss Green on the board tonight under the guidance of Frenchie, the companionship of No Shave Shane, and I Wish He'd Shave Rob, Dana Pinkston, who can't catch a basketball. She did the first time. You can't see that. She's going to go to the bus store as soon as she gets home to catch a buzz. They're out of you, they call. They're out of shrimp. Ha ha. Hey, the jerk store called. $100 roosters for 50, all the way down the line. Furlongs, 50 for 25. Here comes JoJo, here comes JoJo, here comes JoJo. Oh, I wonder why we're playing that. Did the little trainee tonight in the director's chair, did she win the Masters? Wow, go girl. Screw you, that man who got kicked off the Masters for saying that women couldn't play because their boobs got in the way. Ben Bentley. God, what was Ben's name? But Amber, obviously. God, I even had him on. Remember the announcer, the famous announcer from England. None of you guys know upstairs who got kicked off of television? Ben what? Not Ben Kingsley, no. He said that women's boobs got in the way and that they couldn't play golf, and he got fired forever. And also, and he called himself Bentley. Gosh! And of course, Gary McCord, he said that the greens were very, very, very fast at Augusta. He said it in a different way. And I don't like Gary McCord, but he did not deserve to get kicked off the Masters at all. All of you, thanks for tuning in to the show tonight. And those people right there on your screen are really the only ones that make it go.